Welcome to visualsp.com, your contextual, just-in-time learning solution. In this short video, you will learn how to create a product catalog using search in SharePoint 2013. As you're about to see, this is a much simpler and smarter way.
So we're going to look at, you know, building catalogs, your list. Each list can become a catalog. So what if you could build things like what you see here, right? This entire page. What do you think this is? That I clicked on edit page and put some text here, an image here, and then clicked on publish? No. This is a single search web part that pulls from a list with a single title column, description column, hyperlink or picture column, and I limit the search results to one result. I can make contextual. I can say, hey, here's the Contact Us page. And when you click on Contact Us, I look at who you are from your user profile and show you the Contact Us with the closest office possible, because we're an organization with multiple offices across the globe. This way, I can give the same URL to everyone across the globe. But when they get to the URL, because of a search-driven page, it'll be different for everyone that arrives to it. It's great for me because I only have one page to manage. Look at this here. This is an example. This is a page. This is a page. This is a page. This is a page. Do you think that this, somebody click on edit page and wrote the content? You think that here somebody click on edit page, wrote the content? Or even the content itself here? You think we clicked on edit page and wrote it here? No. This is a one list item. This is 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 one list item. And it's created somewhere else, somewhere boring. And when we display it, it's displayed in the way that we want. Tomorrow, if we need to change this design, we can easily. If it needs to be responsive, we can easily. This is the other examples I was showing you earlier. I forgot to show you this one as well. There's tons of things that we can do. Everything you see is search driven. So let's kind of build something together. There's tons and tons of things, and I wish we had even more time. May go a 5 minutes extra here. So, and don't worry, not into the questions, I mean, don't worry. So what I want to show you is I have in my content catalog here, I have a list called products. This list is a regular list at the moment. This list has a bunch of metadata. It's nothing fancy at this moment. There's nothing particular about this list. It's a regular list. This is a column with a picture, an image, hyperlink. This is a regular list. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to tell this list that in the list settings, I want this list to become a catalog. And you don't have to do this, but I want to show you all of this. I'm going to enable the list to become a catalog. If you don't see the catalog settings on your list, make sure that in your site, there's a feature called cross-site publishing that has been activated. Then I'm going to say whether I want the catalog itself to be anonymously stored in the search index. It doesn't mean that the list is becoming anonymously available. It just means that from now on, this list can be pulled from the search anonymously, but it doesn't mean that everyone has access to the list. Look at this. This is amazing. I can build URLs using my metadata. This is my columns. So I can say, you know what? You're going to take the group number. That's going to be part of my URL. And then you're going to take the title column of my list items, and you're going to put that as the URL at the top as well. How do I want to build the navigation? I want to use my column item category in my list to build this navigation. Let's click on OK. And while I'm going to have to launch the search engine once again so that it passes through and realizes that this here is a good thing. My SharePoint is the fastest SharePoint in the world, right? You click things and things appear. So I'm going to do a full crawl here because I told this list I want it to be a catalog. So we're going to let it happen. While this is happening, I want to talk to you about how I built this other pages, this overlay, for example. How did I build this, right, that you're getting at the end of this session? Well, it's simple. You go to any site, right? Let's click on tour. And let me just delete this quickly. Edit page. I have this hiding my page here on the right-hand side. There we go. Delete my web part that's on a page. With SharePoint, what you have, right, we're going to clean. There's always this leftovers. There we go. With SharePoint, you can insert two types of web parts for search. Well, there, you have many types of web parts, but there's two that you use. I either use the content search web part, which is my favorite, but only available in E3 plans in Office 365 and SharePoint 2013 Enterprise. So if in case you don't have access to the content search web part, you can use search results web part, which is essentially 99% the same thing. I'm going to use the content search web part. And by default, it's going to show me the last three modified items. But don't worry, we can change this. So I'm going to click on edit the web part. And it's going to ask me on the right-hand side if I want to change what I'm going to query. So this is you building search-driven sites. You go and get whatever you want. So, and you say, how many results do I want? 3, 20, 50? You click on change query, and you're going to have to use search to say what it is you want to find from your search index. So you can use the easy mode or the quick mode, they call it. I like to switch to the advanced mode because I find it fairly easy. In fact, I'm going to erase the things that look complicated to show you that it's not that complicated. Basically, by default, the search web part will show you everything in the search, right? Because this is what we've selected. Then you provide filters to narrow down what you want to see. And what the way that this works is you insert a managed property. You know what managed properties are, right? Managed properties are is that shell in which we use with search that references our columns, our crawl properties. So for example, here it says take the managed property path and whatever result in the search has this in the value of this managed property, show it to us. So I'm going to change this and I'm going to put this other URL in query. Oh, there's an S too much. Test the query. So I can see on the right hand side that I'm starting to get, but I only want these three sites. I don't want the pages to show up. So I'm going to have to figure out what is the managed property that says only return sites. Thankfully, there is a wizard here. I can choose all my managed properties and I can filter. This is all the managed properties that I created. In fact, I can take title contains a specific manual value and project. This is one way that I could do it, right? I add the property filter and look, it shows how from now on I know how to create it. If I test the query, I'm only getting results where the title property in my entire URL here has the word project in it. But I only want to have sites returned. So I'm going to click on only return sites and click on add keyword filter. I can click on test query and voila. I can click on OK. Click on OK. But before I click on OK, I can even change the design. Display templates allow you to build a design using HTML, CSS, JavaScript, you know, things that people actually know on the internet to build whatever look you want for the results that are about to come out. So I can say, yes, I want a list with image on the left and three lines on the right, but I can choose a different look and I can choose a different container, but I like it like this, but I do want to change the property mapping. The display template, the design that is being used, is going to use different variables, right? So I can choose, you know what, for the picture URL on the left-hand side, what I really want you to use is the manage property. Remember what manage properties are. They're the most important thing here. There's a manage property. I know that in a SharePoint site, I put a site logo. So I'm going to see if there's a, oh, there it is. There's a site logo manage property, and I'm going to put that in the display template or this design for the picture URL. So let's click on OK. And look what we have done. I've created a way on my page to dynamically go in a URL and pull every site that has the word project and display it and put the site logo here on the left-hand side. What does this mean? If tomorrow my boss calls and say, we need to change how these are presented, I don't care, because the content is actually where people work. If I go to sites, if I go to slider, right? It's these sites over here. People are working. I do not impact these users. I don't impact their authoring. I don't impact anything. But this year, when I'm presenting the data, I can say, you know what? We're going to create a new display template, or we're going to use a new display template that shows it as a slider with a large picture. And we're going to make sure that the picture being used, now we know it by heart, is site logo. We're going to click on OK. And we click on Save. And I just presented the same information in a new way. And I can go further than this. I can say, and the user profile. There's tons of things that you can do. Now, lastly, we're going to finish off with, remember my list of my list of products? Now, we just said we wanted this to be a catalog. Now, pretend that your list of products is your list of announcements right now. Or pretend that it's your list of offices. Pretend it's your list of events. We're going to go in the publishing section. This is a site, another site that has branding that people are just going to come and view. Nobody's going to come and click on edit page. What we're going to do is we're going to go to site settings. We're going to click on manage catalog connections, and we're going to connect to a catalog. Thankfully, my products catalog, well, my list products from this URL is now available for me to connect. I'm not going to change any of the default settings. This is not an error, typical Microsoft stuff. We're just going to leave all of the things exactly as they were. And we're going to use an existing, we'll create a new page. We're using our master page, our custom master page, our branded master page. Basically, I didn't change anything here. I'm going to click on OK and look at what happened. Well, let's wait for it to load. How's everybody doing? Life is good. All right. Look at what happened on my site. I've got a navigation. The navigation, if I open up in another tab, if I open up my catalog, my list, it's the item category column here, laptops, right? I have laptops, audio, camera, phones. Now, it's the navigation. And look at this. It's showing me the content from my list. But better yet, I'm on the same page. I'm on the same page. I'm on the same page. I'm on the same page here. I'm on the same page still. I'm still on the same page. So, in fact, in my intranet right now, I have one physical .aspx page. If I click on edit, I can edit the template, not the affected URLs. And you'll see that I have the content search web part in it that basically looks at the navigation, and based on what people click, it filters the list here that the search picked up and is displaying in front of you. You can edit to change the display template so you can look at it in a different way, right? It's the content search web part. I can say, you know what? I want to see infinite scrolling, and I want to see the items in a different way. Maybe I want to see them with gallery items and click on OK. Right? And now my items look like this, right? And a bit different. And all of them are impacted, all because it's using the same page. If I click on an item, well, we didn't design this one, but this is the result of the title column, the author column, right? The color column, the description column. All of it is search driven. Look at my URL. Remember? /cameras/category/group number/the title column. I have friendly URLs. I don't have /all pages/ASPX ? I can build a lot of things.
This video is a part of a complete one-hour course titled Exploring New Search in SharePoint 2013. In this course, you learn the following: the power of new search in SharePoint 2013, the advantages of building a dynamic and contextual intranet, using Search Web Part for adaptive design, how Office 365 is built using the search concept, how to use continuous crawl, understanding results types, and more. To take this course, click the link below or go to visualsp.com.